mucormycosis or a lesion in a patient with COVID-19. Let's see the case report. A 50-year-old female patient complains of painful lesion in heart palate. The patient was isolated at home after receiving the diagnosis of COVID-19 via RT-PCR test. The diagnosis was made approximately 8 days before the consultation. Her past medical history showed that she had type 2 diabetes. Patient reported wearing of removable partial denture. She reported that a small lesion appeared on heart palate with no symptoms. At this point, she stopped wearing the prosthesis. 5 days later, she noted that the lesion increased in size and accompanied by mild pain in the area of lesion. And on day 7, the pain became more severe and irradiated across the entire palate and middle third of face. Clinical examination shows a deep ulcerated lesion located at the center of heart palate. The bone was exposed and the lesion measured around 2 cm in diameter. The lesion surrounded by an erythematous halo, the borders appears lobulated. In diagnosis, incisional biopsy was performed under local anesthesia and radiographic examination shows a maxilla with normal contour without sign of significant erode area. Histopathological examination shows ulcerated lesion with coagulative necrosis, hemorrhage, abundant neutrophil, necrotic material, especially in blood vessel wall. There were many large non-septic hyphae with thin walled and branches at 90 degree. Then special stain for fungi-like periodic acid shift, which confirmed the diagnosis of mucormycosis. Let's see the management. The patient was quickly referred for hospitalization. Then the treatment was started with IV amphotericin B in associated with hydrocortisone. After 10 days of IV medication, superficial debridement of lesion was conducted. Diabetes was also controlled during hospitalization. After 1.5 months of hospitalization, the patient sent home with no pain and any other symptoms. What is mucormycosis? It is a rare and potentially lethal invasive fungal infection caused by saprophytic aerobic fungi, which colonize the oral and nasal mucosa and paranasal sinus. This disease usually evolves rapidly in immunocompromised patients, those with uncontrolled diabetes, uncontrolled HIV infection, malignant hematological disease, and solid organ transplantation. The most common clinical presentation of mucormycosis is rhinocerebral infection followed by pulmonary, cutaneous, and subcutaneous lesions and disseminated diseases. The hallmark of mucormycosis is tissue necrosis resulting from angioinvasion and subsequent vascular thrombosis.